Do you want to know the number one secret I have been using for years to thrive in a career in sustainability? In this video, I am going to share a simple strategy with you that you can implement right now for fast results. A lot of people do not know this, but the reason why I have been able to transition into sustainability and achieve great results so fast is because of one thing. In this video, I'll share exactly what that one thing is, and I'll show you how you can implement it as well. So make sure you watch this entire video. Now, before I do that, let me recap what I have covered in the last two videos. I showed you why self-teaching and not having an expert to work with you is not the best way to achieve your transition or thriving into sustainability. I also explained why the sustainability blueprint works better than anything else I've seen so far. I also shared exactly how you can get started implementing the sustainability blueprint. In case you have not watched the first two videos yet, make sure you do that right now, because we covered a lot of important things in those videos and you do not want to miss out on them. I am really excited because I'll share something with you that has made my life so much easier, and nobody else teaches this. I call it materiality concept. So let me walk you through exactly how it works and how you can start using it today to transition and thrive in sustainability a lot easier and faster. To succeed in sustainability, you must be able to define the priority areas that you will focus on. Materiality is defined as those items that have a direct or indirect impact on an organization's ability to create, preserve, or erode economic, environment, and social value for its stakeholders and society at large. Materiality concept is the method to identify and prioritize the issues that are most important for an organization and its stakeholders. With materiality concept, you will have an opportunity to analyze your organization's risks and opportunities and to eventually readjust and improve the organizational strategy. The concept of materiality will also provide you with the opportunity to understand where your organization can create or reduce value for society and other stakeholders. A well-done materiality assessment will be a way of making an organizational case to senior executives about why and how to become sustainable. The concept helps you to spot trends and therefore anticipate emerging issues that will require consideration by the organization. Materiality concept will help you to focus your efforts as well as allocating your organizational resources better. Now, talking about materiality metrics, it is important to note that this truly is your game changer. It will enable you to focus your energies into the most relevant issues within your organization. Now, to determine those most relevant issues within your organization, two factors are important. Number one is about the business impact that each or organizational impact that each one of these issues that you're going to choose, how is it going to affect your organization? The second point is about the stakeholders and their interests. So how are the stakeholders interested in that particular issue that you have chosen? Now, the process of materiality will be able to help you to identify, you know, the issues that will lay on the topmost right corner, because that's where the impact is. And indeed, all your concentration should be in this area. Now, let's go back and take a good example. Assume you are in the banking or financial sector. Now, some of the issues you might find within that sector is about data privacy, is things like environmental products, is about customer service, is thinks about, you know, the green product that you're providing. And the most important thing is to map them, you know, in terms of what impact do they have to the business, and also how is your stakeholders interested. And for sure, you'll be able to find that things like green products, data privacy, and such issues will come on this corner. This is the most important corner, and where indeed you should be able to put your effort and almost ignore all these other matters, because we don't have all the energy, we do not have all the resources to implement all the issues. And if you focus on this section, what clearly it means is that you are going to thrive within sustainability, and this is because of your materiality matrix and analyzing what is material for your organization. And that way, we will succeed, we will be able to thrive in sustainability. That's pretty cool, right? Now, what I want you to do is to give this a try today and tomorrow. Develop a materiality matrix for your organization and determine the material matters that are relevant. If you have enjoyed this framework, then I've got some good news for you. In my upcoming Transition and Thriving in Sustainability online course, I will be giving away all my best tricks, such as building your sustainability toolkit, integrating sustainability in your organization, and organizational imperative for sustainability. The course is going to launch in a few days, so make sure you keep your eyes open. This is going to be the best and most up-to-date training I've ever released, and it contains everything I ever learned about sustainability. In the next video, I'll show you the complete plan from the beginning to the end that you need to follow to transition and thrive in sustainability. I'm literally drawing the curtains and showing you every single step you have to take. You do not want to miss that video, because I literally share the complete game plan with you. Thank you so much for watching this video, and stay tuned for the next video. I'll see you there.